lovely ladies, and welcome back to my channel all about Zanny B Davis, where I speak about pregnancy, hypnobirthing, and new mom life. How are you ladies doing? This week I am going to be busting some myths. I almost got the tight tongue there. Busting some myths on some beliefs that we are having as new moms around pregnancy, around birthing, and about new motherhood. So let's get into it, okay? So before I got pregnant and before I became a mom, I kept hearing from every single mom and their grandmother, oh, I'm so tired. I have no idea what I'm doing as a mother. Oh my gosh, I'm so stressed. There's so much going on and I cannot sleep, or I have a lack of sleep, or I'm just so tired, right? Like, you hear these things all the time, right? But I'm here to call BS on all of that, okay? That does not have to be the way when it comes to becoming, well, being a new mother. I, for one, know better than that. Yes, I know the kids are always running. Like, my little daughter, she's 16 months old. Yes, she does not like to sleep. She definitely fights sleep every minute of every day. She's sleeping now, right? She does fight sleep at night. It's really hard to get her down. But I'm telling you, you do not have to be tired. You do not have to be overwhelmed. You do not have to be stressed, right? This is just a preconception that a lot of people have. And it comes down to one thing only. Your decision. Have you decided that this is what's gonna be for you, or have you decided that that's not for you? For me, I was like, I'm not having it, okay? My husband and I waited almost 6 years, well, 5 years plus, before we decided that we wanted to have our daughter. We were ready, firstly because we just didn't feel ready. It was a lot of responsibility, and I myself, I was like, am I ready to become a mother? So I was 31 years old. That was like a year before, because my daughter is one year three months right now. And I was like, am I even ready for this? But I was also scared about the birthing process. I was scared about the pregnancy. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get really fat. I'm gonna get diabetes and all these kind of things, because that's what you hear. But then I decided, you know what? That is not gonna be my story. It's going to be different. And I'll tell you what I did. The first thing that I did is that I got help. I reached out to people who I knew were living a life that I wanted to live. I was creating my business on the side. I wanted to have Zayna so I could stay at home and work from home and everything else. And I was like, I know mothers who are doing it all. They're working from home. They have their babies. They're spending amazing quality time with their family. They have a balanced lifestyle. That is what I wanted. And so I'd reach out to them. I'd follow them on social media. I would join their groups or whatever they were speaking about, or wherever they were, I was there. Yes, I do know that a lot of people do show, you know, like on social media, this perfect life. I do get that, but I do follow people who are real, just like I'm being real here with you. I mean, was it a struggle to begin with? To be honest, it really wasn't, because I think I felt prepared. One of the things that I did, my mom and my sister came up to stay with us here in the UK for the first 3 months of Zayna's birth. Also, my husband is very, very hands-on, and I knew that I could have had her, well, I have him for support. He is so, so good. And even though he's military, I think my biggest concern was that he wasn't going to go away and leave us, even though I think if he did, I would have been able to handle it, because I always make sure that I feel as prepared as possible. And that's where you get your confidence, right? And I spoke about this in the last video. It's always about being prepared to build your confidence. So if you have that information, if you have that support, you're going to become confident. And that is why I am so determined to show new mothers, if you're planning to have a baby right now, if you're a new mother right now, you do not have to be tired. You do not have to be overwhelmed. You do not have to be stressed. And you can totally know what you're doing, because it all comes down to you planning ahead, getting information, and seeking help. Those are the three things, right? Planning ahead, seeking information, and seeking help. Do not be afraid to ask for help. This is why I created my first time mom community. The link is in the bio. Well, not the bio. The link is in the bottom for you to join us, right? This first time mom community, we offer information, support, you know, love, in a non-judgmental community where you can come ask your questions, the struggles that's happening for you. Every single month we have a guest expert who is a mom, most likely she's gonna be a mom, but also just like midwives or whomever, who's gonna be sharing on topics that you're struggling with. We are gonna have that information there for you. Every single week I go on live, we have a chat, you could come on, we could socialize, we could have a cup of tea, and you ask your questions or whatever you need. That is where that community is, well, that's why I created it, right? So I just want to say to you, do not believe the lies that people have out there that it's going to be really tiring. And yes, of course, a new baby, we all know they're a tiny human, they're getting accustomed to this world, but it all comes down to preparation, right? And it's the same thing with my hypnobirthing. I was like, you know what? I do not want to have a horrible birthing experience. I don't want to have hours and hours and hours of labor. That is not for me. I do not like pain and I do not like to take medication. Something has to be different. And I went out and I basically looked for the information. I found hypnobirthing. I did the hypnobirthing course, and unbelievable to even to me, because I found it extremely miraculous. I gave birth within 3 hours naturally to my daughter, right? At 31 years old. And I know that's not very old, but it made me feel really old, because I know obviously there's younger mothers out there and everything else, but you can do it too. It's just about preparation. So you've got to decide that you're not going to be one of those mothers who are always tired, who are really stressed, who are really uncertain about what they're doing, feel like they don't have a clue. You can decide to be otherwise, especially if you know you planned this pregnancy and you waited so long for your baby. You can do it. You could be happy, you could be calm, and you can be confident. Let's even speak about the pregnancy, right? Like, as I said before, I was scared. I was like, I don't want to have swollen ankles. I don't want to be really, really fat. And I didn't gain much weight. I was actually weighing 55 kilograms before my pregnancy. And during my pregnancy up to my heaviest, which was like the final month, I was 60 kilograms. I kind of just gained 5 kilograms. And I wasn't starving myself. I was just eating really healthy. I was eating healthily and I was staying fit. I was doing Pilates, well, not Pilates, pregnancy yoga. I was walking, I was swimming. I was just trying to be as active and fit as possible. And that's the same thing. Like, you can take control of that. Like, diabetes run in my family. My dad is diabetic, my mom is hypertensive, and my sister actually at 17, she developed high blood pressure during her pregnancy. And I remember thinking to myself, like, I am not going to go down that road. I'm not going to be diabetic. I'm not going to have high blood pressure. I choose not to have that. And I definitely did not develop any of these conditions throughout my pregnancy. And that is because I am disciplined, and you can do it as well. Like, I love cake. Everybody knows I love cake, right? But I make sure I'm not going to sit down in one go and just have like a huge slice of cake or whatever. I will have like a tiny bit of cake at a time. And sometimes a cake will last me like weeks. I'd have it in the fridge, in the freezer if I have to, because I'm not like a glutton. I would try my best to just be really moderate with everything that I eat. So that's the same thing. Like, you have got to decide to take control of your situation and allow it to be different. So my question is to you right now is, like, what are you choosing? What are you deciding for your pregnancy, your birth, and your new mom life? Do you want to look like these mothers who are like pulling their hair out and looking really stressed, looking really rugged and all of these things? Or do you want to look like amazing, calm, relaxed, like happy, right? Like, I'm not a fully put together person. As you can see, I'm not really into makeup and hair and all of those things. I'm like really natural. I love being natural. I love just being relaxed and comfortable, right? But a lot of people kind of don't believe that I am kind of like a mom unless you see me with my daughter, because I don't think I look haggard or stressed or anything else. And people say to me, like, how do you survive and your daughter doesn't sleep? And I'm like, you know what I do? I try different things. So some of the times I make sure I take her out very often throughout the day for walks or whatever, so she can be really tired, so she's sleeping now. My husband is a very huge form of support. I said that to you guys already. He is so hands-on. So if he comes home from work and I need some time, he would take her off of me for a bit. And also, like, I ensure that I spend quality time with her, and I don't feel like, if, oh my gosh, I haven't spent enough time with her and I have so much to do, blah 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 blah. I spend quality time with her, and sometimes I try to implement her in a lot of things that I do. Like when I'm working out, if I'm cooking, she's in the kitchen with me, I try to just do things like with her to ensure that we are not like, oh my gosh, this is her time and oh my goodness, I have this to do, right? So it's all about preparation, it's all about getting informed, and it's all about seeking help and support. Okay, so if this video has helped you, I really hope it has. Leave your comments, subscribe to the channel, and share this video with other first-time mommies, because I'm telling you, I'm calling BS on all of those things. As a first-time mommy, you can be happy, you can be calm, and you can be extremely confident. That is what I'm definitely saying to you, okay? So hope you guys have a wonderful week. If you want to find out more about this that I just shared with you, I have more information on the blog. The link is in the bio as well. And I will speak with you all very, very soon. Stay tuned for next week, where we have so much more information here on this channel about pregnancy, hypnobirthing, and new mom life. Thanks guys for being here, watching my video. Share, subscribe, comment. All right, take care. Speak to you soon. Bye.